Assalamu alaikum. I talk about cryptocurrencies a lot on this channel, but I've never spoken before about one of the largest cryptocurrencies in the world in terms of market cap, which is ADA, commonly referred to by the name of its blockchain, Cardano. As of the date of making this video, Cardano occupies the third largest spot in terms of market cap among all cryptocurrencies. In this video, we're going to talk about what Cardano is, how it compares to its main competition, Ethereum, and at the end, I'm going to let you know if I'll be buying any. Before I start, if you like the content we make on this channel and you appreciate these types of videos, make sure to leave a like, subscribe for more content like it, and visit our home base on practicalislamicfinance.com, where we help people globally build wealth in a halal way. And while you're there, make sure to sign up to our newsletter, which is completely free, so that you can stay up to date on all our latest content and offerings. Also, consider becoming a member on our Buy Me a Coffee page to follow my crypto portfolio, which aims to achieve a 10x return over the next 5 years. Now back to Cardano. Cardano was created by one of the co-founders of Ethereum, Charles Hoskinson, after Vitalik Buterin, the key founder of Ethereum, removed Hoskinson from the Ethereum project in 2014 after a dispute over whether the project should be commercial, which was Hoskinson's view, or a nonprofit, which was Buterin's view. After leaving the Ethereum team, Hoskinson co-founded Cardano, which launched in 2017, some 2 years after Ethereum went live. Similar to Ethereum, Cardano is intended to serve as a platform for smart contracts. While smart contracts are simply programs stored on a blockchain network that run when predetermined conditions are met and without the need for an intermediary to enforce the agreement. The use cases for smart contracts are basically infinite. For example, one potential use case for smart contracts could be inheritance distributions. Upon registration of the death certificate, money could be automatically transferred from one account to the accounts of their heirs based on the wishes of the deceased without the involvement of a third party. I've mentioned before on this channel that as a Muslim, my view of smart contracts, blockchain, and just decentralization in general is a positive one. This is because I see them as enabling equal access to services for more people on more fair terms. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the generous Quran, translated into English, Allah commands justice. With decentralization, there is no central authority that can be corrupted to exercise unfairness, and therefore decentralization and the technologies that enable it are ones that I support. That's the ethical analysis for Cardano as an investment, but what about the fundamentals analysis? To analyze Cardano's fundamentals, I think it's helpful to compare it to Ethereum for a frame of reference, since Ethereum is its main competition. Now, while Ethereum is currently transitioning from a proof-of-work network to a proof-of-stake network to validate transactions on its blockchain, Cardano already uses proof-of-stake. Without going into too much detail, with proof-of-work to verify transactions, miners must use high-powered computers to solve increasingly difficult puzzles. This is extremely energy-intensive and slow. With proof-of-stake, on the other hand, miners put their own crypto holdings at stake to verify transactions. This results in faster transaction times and significantly less energy usage and is therefore more environmentally friendly. Cardano has more experience being a proof-of-stake protocol than Ethereum, which has yet to transition to a proof-of-stake protocol, but is scheduled to in the coming months. So in this respect, Cardano is ahead of Ethereum. Additionally, like Bitcoin, Cardano's native currency, ADA, has a hard cap at 45 billion tokens. This cap creates a sense of scarcity and can help drive up its price over time. I say a sense of scarcity because in reality, the inflation rate of Ethereum, even though it doesn't have a hard cap, is actually currently less than the inflation rate of Cardano. Cardano's public image and stated strategy relies heavily on its claim of following a very academic approach to its code design and tests. Upgrades to the Cardano protocol are peer-reviewed by a pool of academics, and many parts of the Cardano codebase have been rewritten many times by different teams using what is claimed to be very rigorous methodology. So that was basically the good, if you will, about Cardano. The main drawback of Cardano compared to its main competition, Ethereum, in my view, can be summarized in the following. It's not really used for anything, and it's valued at $80 billion. That's a problem for me. Yes, there are some limited examples of Cardano's utility, and the Cardano upgrade, which enabled smart contracts, is still very recent. I understand these facts. However, the fact of the matter remains that about 80% of decentralized applications, or dApps, run on the Ethereum network. Today, Ethereum's usage in the real world dwarfs that of Cardano. Now, this may change in the future, but for now, this is the fact of the matter. Yet, when I look at Cardano's valuation, which is fast approaching $100 billion, it seems to me that a substantial migration from Ethereum to Cardano is already priced in. Because of the network effect, for a protocol like Cardano to take substantial market share from Ethereum, the advantage of Cardano's blockchain has to be enormous. This enormous advantage is unclear to me. Some argue that Cardano will eventually be able to, at least in theory, process about 1 million transactions per second. And that's really its advantage. In comparison, once it launches, Ethereum 2.0 will be able to process 100,000 transactions per second. Now, to put these numbers in context, Visa processes around 1,700 transactions per second. Now, I ask myself, is this the advantage that is going to cause a mass migration from Ethereum to Cardano? It's not clear to me that 1 million transactions per second is even needed. And by the time it is needed, perhaps Ethereum will be able to process a similar transaction load. 1 million transactions per second kind of seems like those truck commercials where they are showing the truck pulling a supermarket or something ridiculous. It's like, is that even needed? When was the last time you had to pull a supermarket with your truck? Obviously, if you're seeking investment in decentralization, adding Cardano to your portfolio will add some diversification. And I think it's very possible that Ethereum and Cardano coexist, sort of like Uber and Lyft, and both do extremely well long term. However, it's hard for me to justify buying Cardano at its current valuation, given the limited number of decentralized applications that are actually built on the Cardano protocol. That said, I would not be surprised at all if the price of Cardano continues to appreciate more in the near term as euphoria in the crypto space swells. But when the tide dies down, I think the less real-world usage a crypto has, the more severely it's going to be hit. If I start to notice a trend wherein developers and decentralized applications are clearly shifting away from Ethereum to Cardano, then I will reconsider my calculus. For me, for the time being, I don't feel compelled to buy Cardano given the fundamentals and its current valuation, and I'm content with my exposure to Ethereum and the other cryptos in my portfolio. Speaking of which, if you'd like to follow my crypto portfolio, you can do so by becoming a premium member on our Buy Me a Coffee page. Link to that page is in the description of this video. Leave a like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video, which was certainly not investment advice. Make sure to do your own due diligence before making any investment decisions. Until next time, make sure to take care of yourself. Assalamu alaikum and peace be upon you all.